Hello everyone! In this episode, we will learn about the last remaining React hook, the useImperativeHandle hook. As you can see, I already have our application up and running using npm start, so let's get to it. I will start by importing the hook at the top of the app.js file, so in here let's just add useImperativeHandle. Save, and now what is the purpose of this hook? In order to understand useImperativeHandle, we first have to understand the concept of forwarding refs. We already know that we can declare and set refs within one component, but how do we declare a ref and pass it down to a nested component? Since we cannot pass ref as a prop using the ref keyword, we could pass them using a different keyword, but this isn't ideal for a custom reusable button or an input component. This is where the forwardRef function comes in. As we already see in its name, it allows us to forward refs and we can then set the ref using the ref keyword. So now we understand how can we forward refs, but what about the useImperativeHandle hook? The useImperativeHandle hook allows us to determine which properties will be exposed on a ref. We can create custom properties or maybe adjust the existing ones. Let's create an example. The goal will be to create a new input component and using the useImperativeHandle hook, I'll try to expose a custom property called focusAndBlur, and when called, this property will focus the input and then blur it after 1 second. I will then render this input inside our nested component and attempt to call the focusAndBlur from there. So, let's start by creating the input above the nested component. So, right about here, I'm going to type const nested input. This will equal a function. And in here, let's return a simple input, just like this. Now, let's render this input inside the nested component. So I'm going to copy this, and I'm going to wrap this in a div, pass our input, add the heading above, and obviously fix the input, save, and if we take a look, there it is. Now, let's also create the ref that will be forwarded right about here. So I'm going to type const nested input ref. This is going to equal the useRef hook. Let's call it. And now let's pass it to nested input like this. So ref is going to equal nested input ref. Save. And as I said at the very start, inside the nested input, we simply cannot access this ref using props because it is a special property. We have to forward it using the React.forwardRef function. Let me show you how it works. We basically have to wrap the nested input contents in React.forwardRef like this. So here I'm going to type React.forwardRef and let's wrap it. Let's wrap the whole component. Then inside we get the ref as the second argument like this. I'm going to call it forwardRef. Finally, we can set the input ref to our forwarded ref like this. Ref is going to equal forwarded ref. Save, and now we have a working forwarded ref. However, we still haven't created the custom focus and blur property. This is where the useImperativeHandle hook comes in. First, we have to create a local ref inside the nested input component and use that ref in the input. So in here, I am going to type const local input ref. This is going to once again equal the useRef hook. And in here, I am going to replace forwardedRef with the local input ref. Now we have removed the forwardedRef, but we will now make use of it again using the useImperativeHandle hook like this. So I'm going to type useImperativeHandle forwardedRef. This is going to adjust this ref. And the second argument is going to be a function in which we have to return the contents of the ref. In other words, the current property. So let's type in a function, and in this function, let's return an object. Inside that object will be our custom focus and blur method. So in here, let's add focus and blur, and this is going to equal a function. And when called, this function is first going to focus the input. So for that, we can use our local ref. So local input ref.current.focus. And as I said, after 1 second, we want to blur it. So I'm going to type set timeout 1 second, and in here, let's blur it. So local input ref.current.blur. Save. And finally, let's make use of that in the nested component. So right here, just below the input, I'm going to create a button that will focus and blur our input on click. So button, let's give it the text of focus and blur, and on click, this is going to equal function, and inside this function, let's do nested input ref.current.focusAndBlur. Save, and now it's time to test it out. Let me refresh, and if I do focus and blur, we can see the input gets focused for about 1 second, and then it automatically blurs. And that's all for this episode. I know this may have been a bit harder than the other ones, but I can guarantee you that you will encounter the use imperative handle hook only very rarely. Since this is the last episode of the series, let me know in the comments what kind of content would you like to see in the future. As always, if you enjoyed the video, be sure to leave a like and subscribe to see more videos like this in the future. Thanks for watching.